Canadian High Commissioner pleased with results of post-Maria support to Dominica. Hello and welcome to National Focus. I'm Kimani Seja. Stay tuned for details of the headline stories and others coming up.
I've been in the business for over 16 years. I get up in the mornings and I look forward to having the next cruise ship berth on island. When the visitor steps off the ship, the first impression is me. And I believe that I need to put my best foot forward and to ensure that everything I do it to the best of my ability. Based on my recommendation, visitors go to various sites, restaurants, bars, and vendors. I take that responsibility very seriously. I would like that the guest receives the same service that I have provided to that individual or guest. This business is bigger than me. Everybody plays a role. The cleaner who cleans my bus, my mechanic who does my checks, those persons ensure that I provide a quality service to the guest. The tourism dollar doesn't just stop with me. It allows me to pay the bank, visit the supermarket to feed myself and family, and have a drink with friends. My name is Jenna Gist, and tourism is my business.
Welcome back now for the details. Canadian High Commissioner to Dominica, Marie Legault, is very pleased about Dominica's progress with assistance given to support the island's farmers and small businesses following Hurricane Maria. Through the Propel project, the Government of Canada provided Dominica with an increased amount of potato seeds, which were granted to farmers across the country.
Following the hurricane, the Canadian government gave us about $360,000 XCD dollars, Eastern Caribbean dollars, and we invested that along with the ministry in potatoes. And so we brought in some high quality potato seeds from Canada, which complemented the potato seeds that the ministry itself was bringing in from elsewhere to be able to scale up the production. We also provided some support in the form of tillers to help the ministry and the farmers be able to prepare their land quickly to get the crop in. We provided some inputs in terms of fertilizers and pesticides, and also worked alongside the ministry to provide training and technical advice. And we had some of our colleagues from around the region as well come in to support that initiative.
Dallas Warrington of Calabishi, who lost all his crops as a result of the hurricane, received 700 pounds of potato seeds and is happy about the harvest. He says he is pleased about the support from the governments of Canada and Dominica and is particularly impressed with the visit from the High Commissioner.
Well, I was very impressed since she's here today because it shows that they are still concerned about the small islanders, you know, and that shows that we can still get assistance from them, you know, and I guess that is a good start, and I'm looking forward for the government and the people of Dominica to continue some kind of relationship with people like the Canadians who are trying to help us in agriculture so we can boost up our agriculture and, you know, be self-sufficient in our food.
He says besides occasional rain, which posed a bit of a threat to his harvest, he has done exceptionally well this year. And with the Prime Minister's mandate to the Dominica Export-Import Agency to purchase and find a market for all the potatoes produced locally, Warrington is relieved that he does not have to face the challenge of sourcing his own market.
Marketing was a little problem for me because when you plant that amount of potatoes, to prepare it, to cure it was a little problem for me. But now Dexter, they are buying it from us and they're going to do all the curing and they're going to look for the markets. The price is not as I would have sold it directly to a supermarket, but I'm much satisfied with what they're giving there because they're going to take care of all the curing and the transportation. That is not my back. So I'm quite satisfied with what they're giving me now.
The delegation comprising the Canadian High Commissioner, staff of the Propel project and of the Ministry of Agriculture also visited Dexia to gain a better understanding of the process involved in receiving the crops from farmers and selling to the market.
We're very pleased with how it's gone, and the main point was to give farmers a step up again, and to see the crops that's coming in and the quick cash that they're getting, that's exactly what we wanted. So it's a very happy day for me, and I think from what we've seen from the farmers, it's a happy day from them. So I'm pleased the High Commissioner's here to be able to see some of this.
The seeds brought in this year were of a better quality, and so there is a much higher yield. The director of Propel Project says Dominica is the second behind Jamaica in terms of success in producing white potatoes in the region. Director of Agriculture Ricky Brumund says this success is an indication of the sustainability of the crop here in Dominica. He says white potatoes will continue to be vigorously pursued by his ministry.
Potato is a 9 weeks cross, a crop or slightly less, and so in a quick time, farmers can realize money in their pockets and also food on their table. And so it's a crop that men can do, women can do, young people can do, and as such we'll continue to pursue that. And like any other crop that we have decided to do, we'll give a lot more energy to potatoes to ensure we get the results we desire for Dominica.
Propel has also provided assistance to young entrepreneurs through the Dominica Youth Business Trust. And on this visit, the High Commissioner was able to see the successful projects of two young entrepreneurs who received assistance. Choco Dominic, which produces instant cocoa powder, and Heaven Scent, which produces handmade soaps and massage oils. The High Commissioner is satisfied with what she has seen from the farmers and the young entrepreneurs.
We've been supporting Dominica through a number of ways since the hurricane, since Maria, and it's great to see the results. It's great to see that we've been supporting potato crops, and we see that, you know, it's time to it's yielding now, so it's going to go to market. It's the purpose of this visit was really to see where we are, meet with young entrepreneurs that we've been supporting through the Dominica Youth Business Trust. After the hurricane, and look at what we can do in the future. Also, I came to meet with some government officials, as well as some ministers, to look at other potential activities that we can do in the future with regards to either electricity or education with schools.
The Propel project is this year in its final year of implementation. It is hoped that the support given through these projects are sustained and can continue to impact the lives of Dominicans. In more news, parliamentary representative for the Mahu constituency, Raben Blackmore, is reporting that the re-roofing project ongoing in his constituency is so far running smoothly. Near 90% of Dominica's housing stock was destroyed or damaged by Hurricane Maria, and the communities of that constituency were not exempt from the wrath of Maria. However, the Honourable Member of Parliament is ensuring through a re-roofing program that ahead of the hurricane season, a successful transition from tarpaulin to galvanized cover is complete.
We had made an application for $8.2 million in the first instance. That was the estimate that we did for the damage that was done to the housing stock in the Mau constituency. The Prime Minister, using his good self and his good office, actually approved that amount.
The project is being done in phases. The target for this month end is to re-roof 69 homes.
You will appreciate that all of it cannot be done at once. So what we have done thus far is to identify the most critical persons, the most vulnerable in all the communities, and then we have a first phase of the roof replacement operation in the Mau constituency, where we were attempting to do by this month end 69 houses, you know, in the first phase. And that's our target.
One of the largest communities in that constituency, Canefield, is currently going through its second phase of the re-roofing project. Honorable Blackmore confirmed that an additional $3.1 million has been allocated for roof rehabilitation in Canefield and neighboring settlement, Belfast.
We have actually gotten some additional estimates for Belfast and Canefield to the tune of $3.1 million that have been submitted to the Ministry of the Prime Minister, who has actually indicated that he'll be actually making the money available. So we'll be starting in Kenfield very soon.
For other constituents who lost not only their roofs, but the entire dwelling and those located in danger zones, relocation will be the response. The parliamentary representative for the Mahu constituency says besides the re-roofing project, houses will be awarded to those without or those who are currently living in vulnerable areas.
We have to relocate a significant number of persons from Benawa Avenue, Campbell. There's a special need for Taru and Layo Park. We have done a comprehensive analysis of persons who need houses in the entire constituency, new houses. And I can say that based on the assessment that we have done, which is scientific, we 311 families, well over 800 people in the Mau constituency are in need of new houses.
As a start to addressing this need, the Honorable Prime Minister and Minister for Finance and Housing, Dr. Roosevelt Skerritt, has allocated 100 homes to families. Those homes are expected to be seismic and hurricane-proof, part of the 1,000 climate-resilient homes to be built across Dominica by government.
The Prime Minister has awarded 100 houses, houses that we saw, of course, being handed over a few weeks ago to some of the residents in Point Michel. Those similar houses will be constructed in the Mau constituency. We also have designs for apartmentary structures.
Taking a look into the progress of the project with the Member of Parliament on Thursday, GIS News spoke with some recipients who expressed their gratitude.
Oh, I'm so happy to see my roof cover because I was under tarpaulin and I was wetting. And I have to say praise God for my parent and my Prime Minister Roosevelt Skerritt to make a good job for me. Now I can say I'm happy, 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 how happy I am. I'm so happy until I see my parent today.
And finally, the twin communities of Dubla and Biosch will benefit from a cash injection of over $600,000. This will be used to repair the roofs of those who suffered damage to their roof as a result of Hurricane Maria. On Thursday, a small handing over ceremony was held to present the check to the chairperson of the village council. The Honorable Parliamentary Representative for the Collyhaw constituency, Lady Catherine Daniel, says government is committed to ensuring that citizens are prepared to face the upcoming hurricane season.
It's in this light. We have 40 recipients from Dubla who will be getting assistance for their roof out of the 72 people that they assessed. Well, this financial assistance is for 40 people. In Biosch, though 11 people were assessed by the group, but because of other submissions, individual submissions, we have 17 people from Biosch will be receiving that assistance. And as the work progresses, we'll be helping more and more because it's the Dominica Labour Party's principle to help people get out of their situation and to build homes that are more resilient.
Just a few months post to Hurricane Maria, the Collyhaw constituency received $250,000 for the renovation of homes. 208,000 of that total went to the Dubla Village Council. The Honorable Parliamentary Representative encouraged the recipients to use the funds that will be given to them for the intended purpose.
I just want people to use their money wisely. Do not spend it on other things. Do not spend it on big glamorous things, but use it for the betterment of your roof, your house, to make you safe. Do not use shortcuts because you want to save a money, because at the end of the day, if a Category 5 hurricane strikes, you will be the one that will not be getting the benefit of the assistance that we are giving.
Beneficiary Joanna Ambo shared these words of gratitude.
I want to say thanks a lot to this government who see the need, you know, to help the people of this country. There is no other government who think as they do. It's because of the vision of the Prime Minister, who has a loving heart, kind heart, a caring heart to the needs of his people. I want to thank also our PAREP who do her best in trying to assist many of us here in this community.
And that's the English segment of the news. Shakira Perry is up next with Creole Highlights.
Bienvenue à ce nouvel accueil, nous sommes Shakira Pair. Des communautés Dubla et Bioche qui bénéficient de plus de 600 000 $. L'argent sala, c'est pour manger tête caille à constituency sala pour les gens qui ont tête caille après Cyclone Maria. J'ai dit une petite cérémonie pour place à Dubla pour faire une présentation de la chef village council. Mam palema pour constituency Collio, Honorable Lady Catherine Daniel, de gouvernement qui a fait commitment pour faire cette toute nationale bien préparée pour l'autre saison cyclone là qui a venu. Il dit c'est à manière ça la gouvernement qui a poursuivi assistance par constituents pour manger tête caillou. Et puis moi, après cyclone là, constituency Collio a soulevé 250 000 $ pour réhabilitation caillou. 208 000 $ hod l'argent sala aller pour manger kay en double. Mam parlement la encourager ces moun la qui ka benefice hod assistance la pour servir l'argent la pour manger tête kayo pas pour d'autres bagay. Yon resident qui ke benefice hod l'argent sala c'est Joanna Ambo. Ambo oui monsieur premier ministre la et puis mam parlement la pour assistance la il ka resouvri. À d'autres nouvelles, Dominique Tappé est ambassadeur neuf de Sweden. Mercredi, Her Excellency Elizabeth Eklund fait présentation credentials libre à président Dominique, His Excellency Charles Savre. Pendant une petite cérémonie, His Excellency Savre prend opportunité là pour remercier le gouvernement Sweden pour assistance là yo ba Dominique après cyclone Maria. Ambassadeur neuf l'a dit, il a continué pour travailler pour une bonne relation entre Dominique et Sweden. Il dit après Cyclone Maria, Sweden supporte Dominique, les offres assistance available par UNICEF et puis Red Cross. Sweden aussi fait commitment pour aider Dominique en plan là pour venir premier pays là, la terre qui s'approche changement climatique. Dominique et puis Sweden établit relations diplomatiques à l'année 1978, même l'année là, Dominique venait une nation indépendante. Et puis finalement, député premier ministre et puis ministre pour l'agriculture, Honorable Reginald Ostry, parle contre plan l'INI pour réorganiser le ministre agriculture là pour travailler plus meilleur et puis planter. Honorable Ostry dit si Dominique n'est pour faire succès à l'agriculture, changement n'est pour faire. Honorable Ostry dit tout de suite ministre là qui engage une activité qui veut planter tout un pays là. Ministre la aussi dit planter ka joué un important part à faire manger à pays là. Gouvernement ka fait commitment pour aider planter quand yo fait une facilité en aid bank available pour planter qui veut taper l'argent pour grandir jardin yo. Honorable Ostry ka parlé pendant AGM aid bank mercredi Simensala. Ça c'est tout pour nouvelle aquayol, non moi c'est Shakira Pair. Ni a bon weekend. Au revoir.
And that's it for National Focus. Be sure to follow GIS on facebook.com/GIS News Dominica and also follow us on Twitter at GIS Dominica. You can also catch up on past National Focus newscasts on our GIS Dominica YouTube channel. From all of us here on the GIS News production team, I am Kimani Seja. Thank you for watching and have a great weekend.